Favorite childhood memory? Was it chasing a sibling around the house, spending countless hours at the park with neighborhood friends, or creating elaborate worlds for you and your toys? Whatever it was, I can almost guarantee that it involved some aspect of play. Active play is one of the most important parts of a child's overall development. It provides them with an opportunity to learn how to problem solve, communicate with their peers, and explore their surroundings. So imagine what your childhood would be like if you didn't have the skills necessary to engage in these play experiences. Unfortunately, this is the scenario for many children with Autism Spectrum Disorder, which I'll refer to as ASD. Children with ASD experience difficulties with their social skills, their communication skills, and they exhibit a restricted range of interests and behaviors. These difficulties can make it really challenging for a child with ASD to engage in play in the same manner as a child with typical development. However, these areas, such as social and communication skills, can also be promoted through participation in active play. Research has demonstrated that children with ASD also have fundamental motor skills that are significantly delayed and of poor quality. Fundamental motor skills are the basic movements, such as running, jumping, and kicking, that are essential for participation in games, physical activity, and active play. I hypothesize that these core motor skills are one of the critical factors holding back children with ASD from engaging in play and reaping its developmental benefits. So that's where my research comes in. I created a community-based group fundamental motor skill intervention for four-year-old children with ASD. This was essentially a mini gym class for these kids and taught them skills such as jumping, kicking, and catching that are essential for participation in play. Following the intervention, we found a significant improvement in regards to participants' motor skills, and these improvements were retained at a six-week follow-up. Through behavioral video coding, we found that after the intervention, there was an increase in the amount of time spent in appropriate play, and a decrease in the amount of time spent in inappropriate play, like sitting alone in a corner. Lastly, there were numerous individual improvements to these participants' social and behavioral skills. So why does this matter? We believe that we provided these young children with the essential motor skills needed to engage in play. As a result, they increased the amount of time they spent in active play and improved their social skills. Therefore, my research not only resulted in functional improvements to these children's motor and social skills, but may have provided them with the opportunity to engage in the play experiences that make childhood so memorable. Thank you.